Donald Trump says he has the best words, even though they're small words, even though they're absurd words. So let's have a word about Donald's words, because lit Trump has led to Trump lit. Believe it or not, even though Donald Trump has probably never read anything longer than a tweet, he's been a big boost to the publishing industry. In fact, there will probably be more books written about Trump than Lincoln. And I'm making this prediction before the impeachment. When it's all said and done, the paper trail for Donald Trump will probably be the longest in history. Of course, not every single sheet is going to be complimentary. And in fact, the more you roast Trump, the more copies of your book get sold. So let's take a look at some of these bestsellers. Let's start with Fire and Fury by Michael Wolff. It was a runaway bestseller, and you knew it was going to be hot because Donald Trump tried to suppress it, which only leads to more sales. This book was so hot, it got people on Team Trump fired. How hot was the book? It was Taylor Swift hot. Let me give you an example. In the first 3 weeks that the book was out, Fire and Fury sold 1.7 million copies. In comparison, Taylor Swift's album Reputation came out around the same time. It sold fewer copies. It sold only 1.5 million copies. Can you imagine a pop star getting outsold by a book nerd? That's how big this book was. And it gets better. Donald Trump has actually started his own category of nonfiction. I'm breaking the news right here. I'm calling it contemporaneous memoir. Here's your word of the day. Merriam-Webster Dictionary defines contemporaneous, pronounce it correctly, please, as happening in the moment. Allow me to use it in a sentence. The generals kept contemporaneous notes on the battlefield. In modern day, this is what FBI agents did when they got called into a meeting with President Trump and got creeped out. They took notes of the meeting. How creepy do you gotta be to creep out an FBI guy? Think about that. On top of it, they wound up using these notes after they got fired. An example of this is Trump's former homie, Comey. Of course, you won't read all the notes. The first editor is the new head of the FBI, Mueller. He's got to go over everything and keep some of it for the court case against the president. But don't worry, there's plenty of juicy stuff left, and you can read it all in James Comey's new book, Trump Lit Has Even Crossed the Border. Mexican presidential candidate and far-left political agent, Obrador in Mexico, wrote a book called Oye Trump, which translated to English roughly as Right Here, Trump. That book's been a runaway bestseller in Mexico. And as part of Trump's worst nightmare, that book will be crossing the border into the U.S. in September, just in time for Hispanic Heritage Month and the November midterm elections. It's international. I guess everyone's getting in on the action. Maybe Stormy Daniels took contemporaneous notes too. Her book will probably go right to film though. I'm Tony, and you've crossed over to the other side.